So good to meet you at this Global Motivational Meeting. We are reading World Scripture Book to inspire and empower a positive vibe for today. As we're reading the book from the beginning, please find all the chapters on our Message to Brilliance channel. This book are helping billions of people, families, communities, countries, and the whole world, and will help you to just read the quotes and practice them. Now we are reading about the destiny. Let's read further about the relationship between destiny and the free will. Rabbi Akiba says, everything is for a sin, yet the freedom of choice is given. The world is judged by grace, yet all is according to the preponderance of works. No affliction befalls except by the leave of God. Whoever believes in God, he will guide his heart. God has knowledge of everything. Oh, my servants, everyone of you is in error, except the one I have guided. So ask guidance from me, and I will guide you. Oh, my servants, everyone of you is hungry, except him whom I have fed. So ask food of me, and I will feed you. And my servants, everyone of you is naked, except him whom I have clothed. So ask clothing of me, and I will clothe you. Oh, my servants, you sin day and night, and I pardon your sins. So ask pardon of me, and I will pardon you. All by thee is accomplished. Sin is the might. Thou watchest thy hand, the work with the chest, his raw and right. All that into the world have come must depart hence. All shall by turn go. Why put out of mind the Lord, master of life and death? By one's own hand is one's affair set straight. Even though God forces the free acts of the human will, freedom of choice remains for God, seems all time concurrently and throughout eternity. Further, let's read quotes from the Second Coming Messiah, Father, Son, and Moon. God is the absolute being, unique, eternal, and unchanging. Therefore, the purpose of his creation must also be absolute, unique, eternal, and unchanging. It follows that God's predestination of his will, that the purpose of creation one day be fulfilled, must also be absolute, as it is written. I have spoken, and I will bring it to pass. I have a purpose, and I will do it. Since God predestined his absolute will absolutely, if the person who has been chosen to accomplish his will fails, God must continue to carry on his providence until its fulfillment, even though it may require him to choose another person to shoulder the mission. For example, God willed that his purpose of creation be fulfilled through Adam. Although this did not come to pass, God's predestination of this providential will has remained absolute. Hence, God sent Jesus as the second Adam. Although God's will to realize the purpose of the providence of restoration is absolute, God predestines the process of its accomplishment conditionally, contingent upon the 5% of responsibility of the central figure, which must be completed in addition to the 95% responsibility of God. The portion of 5% is used to indicate that the human portion of responsibility is extremely small when compared to God's portion of responsibility. Yet for human beings, this 5% is equivalent to 100% of our effort. To what extent does God determine the fate of an individual? The fulfillment of God's will through an individual absolutely requires that he complete his responsibility. Hence, even though God predestines someone for a particular mission, God's 95% responsibility and the person 5% responsibility must be accomplished together before the person can complete his given mission and fulfill God's will. If the person does not complete his responsibility, he cannot become the person God has purposed him to be. No matter what people may say or do, they are subject to the rhythm of heavenly fortune, which power flows throughout the universe. No one has the power to stand against it, so they are inclined to follow along with it. People who follow the right path and alignment with heavenly fortune grow. And prosper along with it. Since they move with its rhythm as it pulses throughout the universe, they are born to live forever. Nevertheless, many Western people want to be masters of their own destiny, but since they disregard the rhythm of the heavenly fortune, things will not go as they want. Therefore, clever and wise Westerners will align themselves with the principle that governs the universe. No one wants to perish, no nation wants to perish. Nevertheless, today so many people are perishing and nations are on the path of decline. Why are they perishing? It is not because of anything I do, but when the very universe opposes them. How can they stand against it? Only people who are aligned with the heavenly fortune and who are obedient to the principle that governs the universe can expect to survive and prosper. This has been the case for the heroes and saints throughout the history. Wouldn't you like to become a hero or a saint? Good question for today. So powerful quotes for today. If you have difficulties, please watch on my time this video, share this video as we end this billion happy life subscribers marathon. Contact me for consultation, cooperation, and become a member of this Heavenly Parents Story community. And leave a comment. What do you think about? See you tomorrow with more powerful quotes. Yours, Coach Nicolae Servala. Bye-bye.